Hello there, my music lovers. I'm Joshua in the file Heaven, and today we're having a look at the O'Reilly A50. This is a wireless speaker amplifier with 50 watts in two channels. This review is going to get crazier and crazier the more we dig into the O'Reilly A50. The unboxing experience is actually pretty interesting. It comes with a ton of accessories. It costs just $170. This is not a high price for a speaker amplifier. And my biggest fear, like yours probably, is that it is not going to sound so good. So we are going to be testing the sonic experience a ton with the O'Reilly A50. Inside the package, you get the Mine amplifier. And you also get a few other accessories, which is a 3.5 to 2 RCA cable, RCA to RCA line cable, power brick, cable for the power brick. We have two antennas because it needs two antennas. We have an adapter because it basically uses this adapter to connect the cables to your speakers. It doesn't really have your typical connectors. With the screws, you need to use these little screwdrivers and this adapter. And it comes with a remote. And this is the most complete speaker amplifier I've seen in this price range. It is the only one I've seen in this price range. I used to review much more expensive speaker amplifiers, so I thought to myself, why not review a very affordable one? So let's find out how it sounds. I'll be honest with you, connecting this looks actually very uncomfortable. Those are the cheapest, most basic wires I have in the house. They are much larger, much thicker, and much heavier than the mini-sized green connector that you use to connect them to your amplifier. It is a true adventure to connect it. I wanted to emphasize on the fact that despite costing just $170...
Follow the instructions in the app to finish the setup.
At the moment of making this video review, I wanted to emphasize on the fact that it comes with two antennas, it is wireless, it has internet connection, USB connection, RCA connection. It's such an amazingly well thought and such a versatile thing. I also wanted to add that this uses that horrible 4-stream app, which I really am not a big fan of. But on the other hand, having line connections, it should be pretty fun to use if you just need a speaker amplifier and if you won't need any of the features. Because if you will need any of the features, it will be a bit complicated to use it. I won't lie to you. The app, the 4-stream app, is not the best thought app in the entire world. Back to reviewing the O'Reilly A50, I am excited. It sounds beautiful, it sounds amazing. It is the best speaker amplifier you can get for those money. I can confirm this, I can guarantee this to you. It sounds as good as a 1000 speaker amplifier, and I'm not even exaggerating here. First thing first, let's start with the bass. The bass is actually a bit largish and a bit uncontrolled, and I've been testing it with the Bouchard S400, the white speakers. I have two speakers, one is black and one is white, the other ones are active. So the Bouchard S400 has a large bass, but it is not the most controlled bass. So to get proper control, you can use the remote and you can decrease the bass quantity. It is a bit boomy, but if you decrease it a bit, it is really controlled, really deep, and it is beautiful in terms of musicality. I am actually amazed by the overall bass performance of the O'Reilly S50. The mid-range is smoother, it doesn't have the most extruded of textures, but it is musical. It is just musical, it is beautiful in terms of detail for this price point. It is just so detailed, and I know that it may be a bit unfair that I've been using such an expensive speaker to test it with, but even with the DALI ECO 2 Mark II, it is able to control them. Those 50 watts that it promises to have in two channels at 8 ohms are no joke. It is actually not hot running, and I am amazed by that. I don't know how it manages to have such power without getting hot, and I've let it run for about half an hour now and it still is not hot. It has a few disadvantages though, and it is not perfect in terms of overall usage, and it is not quite as high-end as some of the better amplifiers, but if you need to get sound to your system, if you need to get a beautiful music up and running, the O'Reilly A50 is an amplifier of your dreams and of my dreams. I'll be keeping this one in my system for a while because I really enjoy how it sounds. It is beautiful. The treble is actually pretty smooth in the flat configuration. It has a little EQ thingy and you can bump up the treble. You can spice it, you can sparkle it, and it is never shouty. It is never harsh. It is never sibilant, it is just a bit more sparkly, a bit more expressive. Music has excellent dynamics, it never felt dynamically constrained to me. And I've tried using it both by using its own embedded DAC. It sounds better if you are using an external source. Even my smartphone sounds better feeding it. You probably can't implement everything at this price point. We are talking about $180. Even Fio K5 Pro is about the same price. It is a bit less expensive, but it doesn't have to drive speakers. So I was not expecting a good DAC performance. It is a decent DAC performance, but I totally recommend getting a secondary DAC. But the amplifier performance is superb for this price point. And I don't joke with those words. It is just superb. I was expecting it to sound like a big potato, but it sounds beautiful. It sounds really, really convincing. This will become like the new Fio of the speaker world, the Arailik company. One of the largest issues I have experienced with it, and I can't really unconnect my wires because I'm going to do even more listening with it, is with this connector. This green connector actually has a bit of an issue because the poles and the connector plugs are so close to each other that at some point your speaker wires are going to be touching. And my speaker wires actually touched while it was running. It stopped playing, it turned off, and then it started right back up, so we didn't burn. Think about this, it doesn't burn if you touch the negative and the positive pole. That is pretty cool actually. I do not recommend doing this. I really recommend you to avoid doing this. It was a mistake, it was an accident. I can't really guarantee that it won't burn for you, but for me it didn't burn, so I'm pretty happy about this. It doesn't really have a fuse, so if you burn it, you are out of luck. But when we are using it, when we are listening to it, it sounds musical, it sounds smooth, it sounds pretty detailed actually, even with YouTube songs. It is a very, very good speaker amplifier. It is beautiful, it has so much power. This was another one of my concerns. I was actually a bit concerned that the company was overly optimistic with the 50 watts at 8 ohms in 2 channels. I thought that it will be very quiet because I had this experience with some Taga Harmony amplifiers. Some of them promise to do damage, but they do no damage besides doing damage to your listening experience because some of them are so quiet. They're just, I need to listen loud. I need my room to be dancing with me while listening to music. And it is able to do that even with hard to drive speakers. Both the Bouchard S400 and the DALI Econ 2 Mark II are fully driven by. They are extremely loud. They are beyond my typical listening level. So beyond 120 decibels loud. They are still clear, they are still crisp, and they are still controlled at the maximum volume. This is unique to me because in the past, I was forced to get extremely expensive equipment to be able to drive those two speakers loud and still controlled. But this one, the Arailik S50, totally does it. But this one, the Arailik A50, totally does it. It is the Amplifier 50. And in the end, the software is not perfect. I don't really like that app. That app is just my nightmare. It is badly drawn, badly taught, and although it works, I just don't like the experience of using it. But using this amplifier as a speaker amplifier, that is a superb experience. I don't really know anything else in this price range that I can recommend more. I actually know a few things that are in this price range, but are nowhere near as good at the Arailik as the Arailik A50. In the end, if you are looking for a high-end experience at an entry-level price, the Arailik A50 is perfect. The Taga Harmony amplifiers that are in this price range are nowhere near close to the Arailik A50. This is a true amplifier. It is a true speaker amplifier, and I was expecting it to be bad. I started with no expectations and it managed to blow my mind away. This is how you should do it, boys. Please take your time and learn from Arailik. It is superb. If you are a bit careful when installing it and install it in a place where you won't need to touch it, it is perfect. You can control it via the remote. It has volume in it. It has everything I have ever dreamt of. It has equalizer settings. It has so many features. And where do you get this type of service? Speaking of service, the Arailik company offers excellent service. It is a pleasurable experience to purchase from them. And this unit is on sale right now. They have many other units, and I am really looking forward to reviewing more. I hope that by the time I'm writing the full written review, I will have improved my experience with the app and I will be able to not complain as much. The app, the streaming app, is not perfect. but using it as just what it is intended to be used, using it as a speaker amplifier, is superb. I love having equalizer options, I love having so much volume, so much headroom, and I love the fact that once you turn the bass down, it is so controlled, so deep, and yet detailed. It is fairly detailed for this price point, and I haven't heard a lot. I'm a bit of a beginner in the hi-fi domain with speakers and with amplifiers for speakers. I know that the best thing that I have had so far is the Adam Audio T7V. This is the speaker setup that I'm using the most. They are active speakers and they need the DAC, but it is pretty much the most balanced experience I have had. But to get proper bass out of them, I had to get a subwoofer too, and that is a purchased system that I'm going to also review soon. It is my personal system and it is something that I love to beats. And using the Butcher DS400 with the Rylic A50, I was able to get to a very similar experience. It is so close. I'm actually shocked by it, because usually you need to spend way more to get close to Adam Audio sound. And I'm not a big fan of Adam Audio as a company, as people, but I am a fan of their products. They make excellent products, and the Rylic A50 is the yes of today's shows. It is a total yes, totally go get it. If you need a cheap, or you don't need to need a cheap, if you need an affordable speaker amplifier with excellent sound, the Rylic A50 is waiting for you. I hope that you have enjoyed watching this video review of the Rylic A50. I hope you'll subscribe to Audiophile Heaven if you enjoyed the content. I hope you'll also leave a like on this video if you found it funny, you found it informative, you found it good. I hope you have the loveliest of weeks in there, and I hope we'll see each other really, really soon. Bye-bye.